Hello, fellow teachers. This is Apollos, and I'm here to help you teach the scriptures with more impact, relevancy, and power. These videos are geared towards those of you that are teaching from the New Testament Come Follow Me manual. And each video covers a different insight that I feel will really increase the power of your lessons. This insight comes from the lesson intended for April 1st to the 14th, 2019, and covers Matthew 16 through 17, Mark 8 through 9, and Luke chapter 9. So let's go ahead and get after it. Insight number one comes from Matthew 16, and we're going to specifically focus on verses 13 through 17. Now, I would start by asking a very simple question. What two questions did Jesus ask his apostles? And then let them look for those two questions and identify them. Now, the first question they should find is, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? To which his apostles give some of the popular opinions of the day, you know, John the Baptist, Elias, some others. But then Jesus asks a second question, but whom say ye that I am? To which we have Peter's famous response, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. To which Jesus responds, blessed art thou, Simon, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. At this point, I would stop and ask the following question. Why do you think Jesus asked the first question and not just the second? Give them some time to work with that and to think about it. Now, whether they identify this truth or make other comments, it's all right, but be sure that the following truth or something like it is identified by either them or you. The source of our beliefs, thoughts, and opinions must not be flesh and blood or the world, but it should be God. You see, that first question sets a crucial backdrop for the second question. What public opinion asserts must not be the critical factor in determining what we believe. What matters is what has been revealed to us by our Father in heaven. He needs to be our major source of truth. At that point, I would ask them to personally contemplate the following question. I would say, now ask yourself, what is the major source of my beliefs, my thoughts, my opinions? The world or my Father in heaven? And hopefully that gets them thinking about that source for them. Where do they find their opinions and beliefs? The internet, social media, friends, movies, television, professors, or what has been revealed to them by God through the Spirit, through prayer, through scripture study. Now, how can we make this a little more relevant to those that we're teaching? I feel that this next line of questioning can be a really fun and impactful way of making this truth really sink deep into their hearts. So I like to set up this little dialogue with them, and you start by saying, all right, let's apply this reasoning to some modern-day situations. What do men or the world say about the Sabbath day? Now, it doesn't have to be the Sabbath day. You can choose whatever issue you like. But to that, they might come up with something like, the world says it's a good day to play golf or watch football. It's a good day to go get some shopping done. It's a day pretty much like any other day. Then you ask, but what do you say about the Sabbath day? And then call on somebody or let somebody volunteer. They might say something like, well, I say it's a holy day. Or I say it's a day of rest. Or I say it's a day I attend church or worship. And at that point, you look at them with a big smile and you say, just like Jesus did, blessed art thou, and say their name. So blessed art thou, Brent, for flesh and blood has not revealed that unto you, but your Father which is in heaven. Then you could do that same thing with as many more topics as you like. You could ask, what do men say about the Book of Mormon? Or about alcohol? Or Joseph Smith? Pornography? And just let them share the world's opinions. They'll have fun with that, thinking about the way the world views things. And then, after each time, you ask, but what do you say? And then follow that up with a, blessed art thou, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto you, but your Father which is in heaven. Now, at that point, I always like to conclude with the very question that Jesus asks, and that's, what do men say about him? What do men say about Jesus Christ nowadays? And then ask them, but what do you say? Now, if you set this up right, I'm confident that this will bring a heartfelt testimony of the Savior, which is a great way to conclude this portion of your lesson. Now, you could just end right there, and that would be fine, but if you want to go just a little bit deeper, you could take the time to share a personal story or illustration of this principle in your own life. Personal stories are very powerful. You could share a time when you felt that God revealed a specific truth to you, or a time when you felt that God answered one of your prayers. Or you could just simply share a commandment that you truly believe has blessed you. And there you have it. Hit like and subscribe if you feel this video has helped you in any way. And good luck and happy teaching.